Hello students, in this video we will discuss the question G, H and I. So let us start. State the difference between cardinality and degree of table. First part of G part of question third. So difference between cardinality and degree of table, you will write heading difference between cardinality and degree of table, and after that you will write in it here in the quick recap, page number 20, in the quick recap, first, second, third, fourth, fifth point will be your answer of difference between cardinality and degree of table. So here you will write first the heading difference between cardinality and degree of table, and under this heading you will write the number of records in table is called cardinality while means jabki, while the number of columns present in the table is called its degree. The number of records in a table is called cardinality while the number of columns present in the table is called its degree. Now let us see the second part of G question. Difference between primary key and candidate key. Difference between primary key and candidate key. You will write the heading difference between primary key and candidate key. After that, you will write the content from page number 20 in the quick recap. So here at the page number 20 in the quick recap, the sixth point, you will write under the heading the difference between primary key and candidate key. You will write first the heading difference between primary key and candidate key, and under this heading you will write the column in a table which can uniquely identify a record is called primary key. It means the column in a table which can uniquely identify a record is called primary key. It means the column in a table which can uniquely identify a record is called primary key. After that you will write while. You will write next line, in the case there are more than one field which are eligible to form primary key are called candidate keys. While in case there are more than one field which are eligible to form the primary keys are called candidate keys. This is how you can write the difference between primary key and candidate key. Now third one is difference between candidate key and alternate key. The same at the page number 20 in the quick recap you will write. First of all, you will write the definition, you will write the heading in the answer difference between candidate key and alternate key. After that you will write from the page number 20 under the heading difference between candidate key and alternate key, you will write in case there are more than one field which are eligible to form the primary key are called candidate keys. In case there are more than one field in table which are eligible to form primary key are called candidate keys. After that you will write while alternate key is a candidate key that does not form the primary key. Alternate key is a candidate key that does not form the primary key. This is how you can write the डिफरेंस बिटवीन कैंडिडेट कीज एंड अल्टरनेट कीज. नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन एच इज स्टेट द डिफरेंट ऑब्जेक्ट्स दैट यू कैन क्रिएट इन माइक्रोसॉफ्ट एक्सेस 2013. स्टेट एच क्वेश्चन इज स्टेट द डिफरेंट ऑब्जेक्ट्स दैट यू कैन क्रिएट इन माइक्रोसॉफ्ट एक्सेस 2013. इट्स आंसर हैज बीन गिवन ऑन पेज नंबर 19. सो लेट अस सी हियर एट द पेज नंबर 19. दिस इज द फॉलोइंग आर द मेजर ऑब्जेक्ट्स दैट एट द प्लेस ऑफ यू यू विल राइट वी कैन क्रिएट इन माइक्रोसॉफ्ट एक्सेस डैश. After that, you will write these four things like this. At the place of you will write we. At the place of your, you will write our. So, here, tables. First is tables, where we can store data in the form of rows and columns. Second thing is forms. Forms are windowed interface that we can create to manage or manipulate data in a table or group of tables. Now next thing is queries. Queries are statements that we can use to filter our relevant data according to our need from a table. Now next is reports. Reports are used to display data in printable format from table or a query. Now next question is what are the steps involved in closing database? What are the steps involved in closing a database? Its answer has been given on page number 19. So let us see. Your heading will be closing the database and access. To close the database, you need to follow these procedures. And first click on file tab, which will make the backstage view appear. Second point, from the left hand panel click on the close option. After that, database will be closed. Now we move on next page number 20. Here the third point to close the DBMS. To close or quit access or DBMS, simply click on the close button on the upper right corner of the access windows or database. So these are the steps to close the database and MS Access. Now all the questions are complete from A to I.